I absolutely love Japanese food, and it's something I've always been dying to know how to make properly. So I'm a sushi virgin until today. I'm going back to the floor to get the ultimate lesson in the perfect sushi. Here we go, in at the deep end.
I've come to the award-winning Aya restaurant in the West End. The sushi chefs here have trained for up to 10 years and are all experts hand-picked from Japan.
Morning.
Morning.
Teaching me today is sous chef Yan Wing Quinn, overseen by sushi master Kara San.
Hi, how are you?
Hi.
Good to see you. Okay.
I'll be tackling three sushi classics: dragon roll, scallop nigiri, and spicy tuna roll. But first, it's back to basics: rice.
So how long would you wash rice for when you first arrive in a Japanese kitchen?
For 3 years minimum.
3 years?
3 years.
Just washing rice?
Kaoru-san, he did rice for 6 years.
Was he a naughty boy?
The rice is washed three times, leaving it soft but sticky enough to mold.
And this is the most important thing for sushi, because we say the sushi rice is the heart for sushi.
Yes.
Yeah.
I've been fast-tracked through years of rice washing, and now it's time to learn how to make my first dish. A real work of art. The dragon roll. Avocado, eel, cucumber and salmon roe, intricately wrapped in seaweed paper called nori and rice. But there's one big catch.
You have to do it within 2 minutes.
You have to do it within what?
Within 2 minutes.
In 2 minutes? That's impossible to do that in 2 minutes.
I've been told to copy Kara-san's every move.
It's an amazing way of fanning out an avocado. Jesus Christ. Huh? Everything's so precise, everything's
yes.
So... It's almost like it's in military fashion.
Next step for Kara-san, the eel. But I'm still struggling with the basics.
The rice sticks to your hands so quickly.
Yes.
Kara-san's almost finished.
It's so precise. Bloody hell's bells. This is for one portion.
One portion, yeah.
I'm feeling slightly nervous because I feel for the first time in my cooking career, after 21 years in the kitchen, I'm out of my depth.
Jesus Christ.
In under 2 minutes, Kara-san's done. And I've only just begun.
It's incredible, the level of concentration. Shit. The amount of work that goes into it, so underestimated.
13 minutes later, dragon roll, eventually done.
Good. All my worries are the timing. 13 minutes, he needs them in 2 minutes.
It's learning on the job from now on. I'm really under pressure. Lunchtime service is starting, and all the sushi here is made to order. It's a full house, and there's nowhere to hide. Kara-san puts me on the scallop nigiri. Nigiri is a simpler rice-based sushi with a fish on top. My first attempt is embarrassing.
When I pick up the sushi, it's been falling apart, so it's not very formed.
Head chef Kara-san has to step in to help me out.
1, 2, 3. Okay, fucking hell.
He can make 6 pieces a minute and everyone is perfect.
Oh my God, the different steps is extraordinary.
I tried to give it one more shot. And Kara-san's patience with me starts to pay off. Maybe I'm not so bad at this after all. Next, an order for spicy tuna rolls containing tuna, chili powder, cucumber, and sesame seeds. It's made using a similar technique to the dragon roll.
Everything has to be so exactly the same size.
But that took me 13 minutes this morning. Have I improved?
Now roll tight, no?
At last, done. And in under 2 minutes.
So far, so good.
Finally, I think I've cracked it. And what do the punters think?
Very fine food. Well, someone, the Japanese chef, made a sushi for us. I didn't know he made a first time.
Oh, I love it.
I'm going to hire him for my restaurant.
Last sushi done. I know it's slightly slow, but in terms of the method, it's very precise. Can I come back? Excellent. Thank you. That was fucking impressive. Bloody hard work, but I can really start to understand why it takes so long to become a top sushi chef. Today, the proof.